Everybody, and welcome you all to yet another episode with Date with DYC. Today, our guest has something special, the art of managing a time well. From volunteering at an NGO, to hosting events on weekends, to having a full-time job. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome our guest, Delise Mascarenhas. Thank you, Delise. Thank you, Delise, for coming to our show. Delise, what is your inspiration behind carrying out this work as a volunteer?
Okay, so I was in the 12th standard when I realized that I want to join an NGO. The inspiration truly was just to make use of the valuable time that I have.
Okay.
And I realized that I was not really making good use of it. And that's when I decided to join an organization. Initially, I also had this feeling that I want to leave a mark wherever I go.
Okay.
And that was my reason. I just didn't know how I would do it, but I knew I wanted to do this.
You want to be an influencer.
Yes, I want to leave a mark,
huh.
A positive mark,
yeah.
However, and in whatever way I can.
Yeah.
And in 12th standard, when I was studying, I realized, I have the time, so I can join an organization.
Yeah.
And that's when Make a Difference happened to me.
And while we talk about Make a Difference, the NGO that you were a part of, a little birdie also tells me that you were the head of the Mumbai chapter last year.
Yes. Well,
and that's such a remarkable thing. So can you like tell us your entire experience of heading such an organization? The Mumbai chapter at least.
Yeah. So basically what Make a Difference does is we work with children in shelter homes.
Okay.
We provide them life support, emotional support and also education. Okay. So I joined when I was in the 12th standard and it's been 6 years that I've been volunteering with them. So I joined as a volunteer and then I realized that, okay, I have more time because after my 12th standard, I was doing my college. So I realized that I had more time in hands because again, college is only from 8 to 12 and then we have a lot more free time. So I wanted to make good use of this and that's when I took up fellowship. So fellowship is a little bit higher than a volunteer.
Okay.
Where you, again, you're still volunteering, but maybe you take a responsibility of a city or of a shelter. So that's how I started growing and started taking up more responsibility.
Okay.
And after 5 years, I took up heading the Mumbai chapter. That is what I did last year. I was the city team lead for Make a Difference Mumbai chapter. That experience in itself was a huge learning experience.
Yeah.
For me because I was leading a chapter that had around 180 volunteers. We have around 100 kids and it was an experience because it was like, again, all the volunteers who come, they're not getting paid. They're all volunteers.
Yeah.
And they all come from various backgrounds. So I know people who are doctors, engineers, businessmen, teachers, product managers. You name it, I know somebody from that field because all of them come from all these different backgrounds.
Okay.
So in a whole, this experience was very enriching. And for a girl at the age of 23 to have that kind of an experience and get exposed to various different people and at the end of the day also making a difference in someone's life has really, really, truly helped me grow.
So wait, you have a full-time job.
Yes.
You volunteer at MAD, which you ended up being the city team lead last year.
Yes.
So are you back with MAD or have you decided to check for greener pastures and like move on in life?
So honestly, there was a time when I realized okay, it's been 7 years, maybe I can work with some other NGO.
Yeah.
give my time somewhere else. But then then the lockdown also happened and I realized that okay, maybe it's not the right time to go and explore other opportunities, but I know I can still continue with Make a Difference, right?
Yeah.
So that's when I realized that okay, I'm not leading the city chapter this year. I'm continuing as a volunteer where I am being a guide to 12th standard children. Twelfth Standard Youth.
So how does it feel like getting back to volunteering from, probably, I think this is like you going back 6 years.
A funny thing is, when I joined the NGO, I volunteered for the position that I'm doing currently.
Huh.
And I was only in 12th standard, right? So imagine being a you know, a life coach kind of a person to a 12th standard when I'm in 12th standard. Huh. Which wasn't right, right? So they rejected me and they declined my interview that time and they didn't give me that position for obvious reasons. But then now life has come a full circle and I'm actually doing the role that I initially wanted to join the organization.
And now they've like put a red carpet, yes, and said, please come and take
I mean,
this.
I also had an interview for this. It's not that I just got it because, okay, you were leading the chapter, obviously, yeah, you can do this. No, I had an interview for this round as well. But okay, yeah, so right now, we've gone digital because of the whole lockdown situation. But it's happening. It's going on.
So wait, so while you volunteer at MAD, have a full-time job, you also host events at various parties and christenings and birthdays and weddings. You are also a very active member in the church while hosting events. Like, so that is, it's not that you do it only professionally, but also do a part of service. And how do you get the time for that?
So I believe if you want to do something, you can make the time for it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's one thing. And second thing, I know that I enjoy doing what I do. So whether I'm getting paid or I'm not getting paid, that doesn't really matter to me. What matters to me is, am I happy doing it? And if yes, then I'm going to do it.
Okay. So I also get to know that you've also delivered a TED Talk.
Mm-hmm.
And what else is left? Like, while you've accomplished so much and you've also given a TED Talk, what else is remaining? Like, tell us your experience about the TED Talk and what is it about?
Okay, A, there's a lot remaining.
Yeah.
It's just the beginning.
This is the beginning.
But my experience of giving a TED, it was a TEDx talk at SFIT at St. Francis in Borivali. And it was, so they came telling us, they came to make a difference saying they want a volunteer who's been actively working with the organization for a long time. And then my whole team said, Denise, you are the right person to do this because you've been doing this for the longest time as of now. So you should go and do it. And that's why I represented Make a Difference and volunteering at the TEDx.
So your topic was
how volunteering made me.
Yeah. Okay. So can you tell us about some cherished moments that you've had? Can you share with us those experiences? Somebody, some event that has inspired you?
Event
or a person? Both.
Okay, there are a lot of people that have inspired me. I can't
probably,
really...
Okay, in during volunteering, if some event has inspired you.
So
the moments that you cherish.
Okay, so I'll tell you one moment that I really cherished from volunteering was last year when we had an elocution competition at the shelter home where the kids primarily only spoke in Marathi. Okay, when we joined them 4 years ago, they only spoke in Marathi. And we had the elocution competition where they had to speak in English in front of a crowd. Now, obviously, speaking in front of a crowd is daunting, but speaking in front of a crowd in English for them is way more daunting, right? Like, just imagine. So, there were girls who came forward to, like, talk, and they were really nervous while they were speaking. And I just gave a small pep talk to, you know, pep them up and get them ready. Hmm. And after that, they came and they spoke. And the whole energy, the motivation, the confidence with which they spoke was really very, very inspiring.
Okay, while we've heard about all your inspiring stories and all the glories that you've achieved, do you have some sort of advice to give young people, those who are watching you right now, on how to use your time well?
Okay, yeah, I definitely do have an advice to give, and I'm so glad you asked this question. What I realized, like now as I grew up, I realized that many youngsters have this one thing, is that they don't know what they want to do.
Except
PUBG, but they don't know what they want to do. You're generalizing. Not everybody plays PUBG. They don't know what they want to do. So my advice to them would be that, you know, when you're in 12th standard or in 10th standard, do things that just you want to do. Just like, don't think about, oh, what is going to be the outcome? How much am I going to get paid for this? What will I learn from this? Don't think about it. Just think about doing something just to make yourself happy. And while doing all of this, probably you will realize that, oh, I don't want to do this, or I want to do this. at least the good thing is you realize what you don't want to do, even if you don't know what you want to do. But yeah, the fact is that you're eliminating what you don't want to do really does make a big difference. So when I joined Make a Difference, I did not know that I would be here for 7 years. I knew I was not going to get paid a rupee for this. I knew that, okay, maybe I was just making use of my time. But what I got in return was a lot more. I got a lot more confidence. I realized that, oh, I'm also giving back to society, but getting a lot more in return. And that's something I take back. Like, all these memories in the past 7 years is something that I will cherish for a really, really long time.
Also, if you would ask me this question, I think everything is an experience. You never lose out on anything.
Yeah.
And whatever you small ways or bigger ways that you contribute into the society, it all just helps you grow as an individual. So while the 6 years, probably you knew that you're not going to get paid for it, but it just made you who you are right now,
yes,
right? And made you such a confident person. Also, yeah, if you would ask me the same question, I think everything is an experience and it just helps you, builds you into the person that you are.
True.
While you volunteer in church and its activities, it just gives you so much confidence. Like because you never know that nobody would have let you head such a big event in the first year, right?
I would have never managed a team in office.
And such a big team, like almost 280 people in like 6 years.
280 was, no.
180 volunteers.
180 indirectly, but 20 directly.
Ah, but 200,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
But 200 people directly, indirectly, jo bhi hai. But you would have never got that opportunity to head a team of 200 in 6 years in office, right? Unless you're super lucky.
Yeah.
But and that's just like tomorrow or probably after 10 years when you actually head a team of 200 people, you've already done that 6 years, you've learned that as an experience, and which is great. So I would also advise young people that please volunteer at church activities. You get paid, you don't get paid. Do not worry about those, because money will come definitely in life.
Yeah.
And there is a lot of money that is there. But for now, just take the experience that you have. Learn, make mistakes. There will be people to guide you, people to mentor you, people to show you the right way. And this is only help you learn.
Yeah, I think learn, make mistakes is a very big thing. And also like just doing something that you want to do. Like don't think about the outcome. Don't think about where it's going to take you. But just do it because, okay, I want to do it right now.
Yeah.
So many people may say, oh, why are you even spending your time? I had so many people who told me, Delise, why are you giving so much time to make a difference? I have so many people. But I know why I gave that time and I stood by it. And I proved to everybody who was against that, okay, this was something that really meant to me.
Great.
So, yeah.
So, now that a one-line advice that you want to give, it's like a takeaway for all those watching this video.
Time is money. Make use of it.
Okay, that's such a great advice. So now we move into the next part of this date. We go and have a small selfie. We'll come back with who we're taking the selfie with. And after that, we've had some games organized, because no date is complete without some games, right? So while we continue the date, we'll go into the selfie mode and we will come back with some games. Are you excited for the games?
I'm nervous.
Why are you nervous for the game? Okay, let's do this. Come, let's do this.
Okay.
I want to take a lovely selfie with our very own Jesus, who's here in blue jeans. So, Delise, are you ready for the selfie? So, selfie with the host, selfie with our dost, and with our very own Jesus. Okay? And we're back with Game Nights with Date with DYC. And in today's game, we have the Flip the Cup Challenge. Delise, do you know this game?
Yes. No.
No? Are you excited for this game?
I don't know.
Okay. So the game is very simple. You have four glasses of, this is Big Cola, nothing else that y'all are thinking about. This is also Big Cola, nothing else that y'all are thinking about. So we have to take each glass, drink it up, and then keep the glass and flip it. We cannot go to the next glass till we flip the first one. And we cannot again flip the cup till we finished all the cola in it.
Okay.
Theek hai?
Yes.
Are you?
How much time do I get for this?
Can okay,
I
so, on? No, you cannot keep on doing this. It's a competitive game between both of us.
Okay.
So, we have 3 minutes for this.
Okay.
Okay.
For all four.
Yeah, and I think the reason we've kept it 3 minutes and the producers of the show have kept it 3 minutes because both of us are useless in doing this, and we'll go like hours and hours, and probably lockdown will get over, but we'll still be playing this. So they have said 3 minute karne ka, baki nahi karne ka. Theek hai?
Yeah.
So 3 minutes for this game. एंड आर यू एक्साइटेड?
यस.
ठीक है, वर्क्स इन 3, 2, 1 गो.
Yeah, you knew you were winning this.
And the winner.
Very nice.
Is.
Very nice.
Me.
Very nice.
Me.
Congratulations.
But I'm so good at this.
Did he flip all?
I don't think
you flipped all.
I flipped all. I can do it again, okay? My eyes closed.
Take these two and finish this also.
No, boss. I can't drink anymore.
With your eyes closed.
I can't drink anymore. But
thank you so much, Jaleez, for giving us your time and coming to DYC and having you over was a pleasure, because we learned so much about saving time and using time well. And we have a small token of appreciation for you. Time at DYC, this is our lovely mark that we have.
Thank you.
And now we have a big token of appreciation, which is the hamper. Yay. For spending time with us at DYC.
Thank you so much.
Yes. And I hope you will come spend more time with us and give us your Vishesh Tipnis. And thank you for watching today's video with Jaleez Mascarenhas. That's today's date with DYC with Jaleez Mascarenhas. And
don't forget to like, love and share this video and subscribe to our channel.
But wait, we have live nights with DYC. So come, let's go on to see our guests perform.
So in our live session with Date with DYC, today we have our friends from OLPS, that is Our Lady of Perpetual Succor, Chembur, Sushant and Denny, and Holy Cross Kurla, that's Leanne. So give it up for our friends from our diocese.
Strength is failing, the end draws nearer. mountain too tall, he cannot move it. There is no storm too dark, God cannot come in. There is no sorrow too deep, God cannot soothe it.
Welcome to Live Nights with DYC. I'm Zakaria Cordris, and I'm here to take you on a trip. Are you guys missing local trains? Are you missing something that was an integral part of your life? So let's go. ध्यान दीजिए अगला स्टेशन है
In the next episode.